Shalom. First, we like to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai, Ba'ashem, Raka Kodash. Like to give double honors to our apostles and elders, a great millstone that do rule well. Peace and salutations to the elect, the hopeful elect, and the one-third, pushing its 100% truth across the four winds so we can see the elect and make it to the kingdom. All right, this is the brother Gabar Shalawar, and I got the brother with me. Hey, we from the GMSM Assembly Camp, you know, just rolling with the spirit and power of Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai. Breaking bread, and really through the spirit jumped on us about pretty much don't let a confusion of face, all right, mislead you to Esau's wickedness, man. All right, meaning don't let someone of another nation that you're cool with, okay, make you think that all of them are okay. Case in point, you may have a friend who looks like an Edomite, but they're actually a Jake. Because what does Jake always say? Not all of them are bad.
Yep.
Well, the reason not all of them are bad, and they, because that's the spirit I want to do a lesson called They is Edom. And they, all right, referring to the Edomites, they say they're not all bad because they got a cool-ass friend who looks like an Edomite, but he's a Jake.
Yep.
So, you know, brothers got to stay, you know, in the spirit, stay circumspect, because, hey, real quick, can you give me that... Proverbs, I believe 16, when a man's ways please the Lord, it maketh even his enemies be at peace with him.
Yep.
You know what I said?
It's the book of Proverbs 16 and 7.
The water.
When a man's ways please the Lord, Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahushai, he maketh even his enemies to be at peace with him.
Right. So you got to remember, hey, the Most High makes your enemies be at peace with you too. So that's on another note as well, a double-edged sword. Don't allow, you know, the Most High making an enemy be at peace with you. Don't let a demon jump in and make you think, hey, this could be a Jake.
Yeah.
Or they really ain't that bad. You see? You got to stay spiritually discerned 24-8, man. Read what you got, brother.
This is the book of St. Hosea 7 and verse 8. Ephraim, he hath mixed himself among the people.
Beautiful.
Ephraim is a cake not turned.
Right. Ephraim is a cake not turned, man. So Ephraim, Puerto Ricans, okay, so-called Puerto Ricans have mixed himself among the all the nations, as all the tribes have.
Yep.
But don't allow confusion of face make you think that these other nations is cool, man. Cause then you now you going off, man. You gotta be able to read and try the spirits, man. So you got to know that's a Jake. Real quick, give me 1 John 4:1 before you get that precept. But please hold your precept, brother. All right? Because that's really a beautiful divide and conquer tactic that Esau has done. Because the scriptures say how when we slept, the enemy came in and sowed tares among the wheat. You know? So you got to also realize that you got tares amongst our people. You know? Hey, you might think you got an evil eye towards a brother, and it's actually a heathen. You got to read this, brother.
This is a book of 1 John 4:1. Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits, whether they are of Yahweh.
Yep, try the spirit, right?
Because many false prophets are gone out into the world.
Right, now give me real quick, I believe 1 Corinthians 2:14, 15 though. The points in 15, spiritual man.
Yep.
And get that real quick. Hey, because brothers got to be spiritual. You got to walk in the spirit of Raka Kodash, okay, which is the Holy Spirit. You gotta walk in the spirit and always evaluate a situation. What's that? Being prudent, all right? Understanding righteousness and judgment, okay? Read this real quick.
It's 1 Corinthians 2:14. But the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of the Most High Yahweh, for they are foolishness unto him.
Yeah, right. And keep going.
Neither can he know them.
Yeah, he doesn't know them.
Because they are spiritually discerned.
Right. So when you're spiritually discerned, see, you got Jakes out here. Now we're spirits got us more focusing on these two-thirds. All right. Because those are the ones that say they're not all bad.
Yep.
So Jake, two-thirds are spiritually discerned. So when they're out here, they're chilling with looking like an Edomite. He's in the hood with him. Might be selling drugs with him. Did a bid with him. His mom a crackhead like your mom. You like, man, that's my nigga, right? And then he like, man, I met some cool ass white boys. They ain't all bad. I'll ride. That's because he's a nigga too.
Right, yep.
He's a Jake too, man. He's in the same. I remember, I'll never forget, you know, the spirit always has me. Man, I got a uncle in the world, all right, you know, who I would call my uncle, been in my whole life, you know, as a personal testimony. He's an Italian, man. and I didn't have the right teachers. Hey, man, this man in and out of jail, always in the hood, all this, man. And when I was first coming in, he basically asked me, like, hey, well, why is it me? Why am I going through these things too? And I wasn't learned enough to give him an answer. But now growing in the spirit, because you an Israelite, man. That's why I see these also these camps that are doing this all black thing. Hey, man, they're scattering sheep, man. Yep. Cause those are Israelite. We had a Jake come to camp that got shunned by IUIC. This man is a so-called Irish.
Yep.
He made a poster of Yahweh Shai for us, man. I went to his job to pick it up, and his boss was an Edomite. And I'm like, clearly this is a Jake. If you couldn't see it before, you see it now, man. So see, Jake's everywhere, man. But these Jakes that are everywhere, and mainly you Jakes of Negroid descent, West Indian Haitian descent, you know of this black and white problem. So when you find a so-called cool white guy or girl and they can vibe with you or they're in your same predicament, now that opens up the door for you thinking all of them are cool.
Yep.
But you don't know those are actually Jakes, man. Okay, keep going.
1 Corinthians 2:15. But it's like it says, but he that is spiritual judgeth all things.
Yep.
Yet he himself is judged of no man.
Yeah, and why is that? Because if we be those men, you can't judge us, man. Because don't the scriptures say, who shall lay charge on the elect?
Right, yeah.
You know, nobody can't, if we be those men, can't nobody judge us but Yahweh Bashmiel Shai. Because we're the only ones that are the righteous judges on this planet. What are you, any of you brothers out there, you one man, two man camps, three man camp, four man camp, wherever you are in your city, your local state, area, town, okay, you're the judge in that city, man. You're the only people that the people someone can go to ask what is right and wrong, man. You're really rulers over that providence, man. If Yahweh Bashmiel Shai is dealing with you, okay? Why do you think the Most High set up the apostles in New York City? You know? Because they're the men over it. But the point, you know, back to the case in point of the confusion of faith, hey, man, you got to stay in the spirit. You got to be able to judge these things, man. Yep. You got to be able to judge these, it says, down to the littlest matters, man. You got something?
Come. This is the book of Sirach, 12 and verse 10. Never trust thine enemy, for like as iron rusteth, so is his wickedness.
Right, and you could tell a difference from a confusion of faith, Jake, and a heathen, man.
Yep.
Like my boss, who's a so-called German and Polish. Don't you know that Polish are, what's the brother... one of the elders in the main camp, he did a lesson on it a couple years ago, and it bugged people out, man. It bugged a chick I knew out too, where they call the Polish the Mexicans of Europe, man. Those Polish people, those are Jakes, man. Just like the brother Marar goes into those Armenians.
Yeah, they're Jakes too.
Those are Jakes, man. Those women are crazy bad, man.
Huh.
All right. Hey, Jake's everywhere. You got all get Hosea's spirit, the Wadi Abashima Shai, Bashima Kokodash. Hosea 1:10.
Oh, yeah.
I was meditating. The spirit hit me, it came back. Yeah, man, Jake's everywhere, man. All right, read that. I lost my point.
It's Hosea 1:10. Yet the number of Israel, it's like this. Yet the number of the children of Israel shall be as the sand of the sea.
Yeah.
Right? It said it shall be, meaning right now, because you got Jakes, you know, eight speckled bird.
Yeah.
You got Jakes that look like the Edomites, Moabites. You know, so everything, man, so on and so forth. You know, case point, him right here, Logic.
Yeah,
he's a rap artist. You know, right now he got blue eyes, but hey, man, he like Edomite, but he's a Jake, man,
straight Jake.
You know,
yeah.
And it says, shall be as the sand of the sea, which cannot be measured nor numbered. And it shall come to pass that in the place where it was said unto them, ye are not my people, there shall be said unto them, You are the sons of the living power, Yahweh Bashmiel Shai.
Right, that's right, man. And that's why someone Puerto Rican descent, West Indian descent, all right, can come up to a camp and find out they're an Israelite, man. But the point I wanted to make was about, because of Hosea, and we still holding Edris, Sirach. The point I want to make, my boss is German and Polish, but he's a straight Jake. We went to a Gook's house and an Elamite's house, man. And I'm looking at him, and I already knew he was a Jake, but it's even when my point is because, you know, you could tell when you're around heathens and when you're around Jakes.
Yeah, totally, yep.
And I'm like, man, this is a straight Jake, man. This is a straight Israelite, man. And the Most High blessed me because he a silly dove. So, you know what I'm saying? Like, he don't got really much of an evil eye towards me, you know, because the spirit of what? A man, if a man's ways please the Lord, you see? Right. So at first glance, if you're not spiritual, you would think he's an Edomite, man. But he's a nigga. Straight penny pinching nigga, man. Straight up. You finish your point, Ciroc, brother. Yeah, and then get that, get I see you firing off.
Back in Ciroc, 12, Ciroc, my bad. Back in Ciroc, 12 and verse 10. 11. Yeah, 10th. The water says, never trust thy enemy, for like as iron rusteth, so it's his wickedness.
Yep, that's the point. That's the point right there we could focus on. Because it says, never trust thy enemy, because his wickedness pretty much is always going to show. So you'll be around heathen, and you'll know it's an Edomite, man. Yeah. All right? We're not saying that, you know what I mean? You'll just know, brothers. That's what we just telling you, is be able to decipher between the two. Don't let a confusion of face mislead you from Esau's wickedness, man. You know, hey, Jake think that Esau cool because of his chick. Jake will straight marry into an Edomite family. They'll embrace him, take him in, because he knocking a little bitch back out. But wait till you have a kid and y'all break up, man.
Yep.
Now you the nigger. You know, you deaf to you. You can't see your kid. That's what they do, man. They'll take your kid and everything from you. And then Jake don't like him. But when you was with him, you was banging for him, man. Banging hard for him, man. Caring, acting like him, wanting to be around him. You see? Hey, man, hey, it's a constant battle, man. What you got, brother?
This is the book of Psalms 55 and 21. The words of his mouth were smoother than butter, but war was in his heart.
Right, because Esau rock you to sleep, man. Hey, Esau rock you to sleep at work, on the field, in court, on your day-to-day, him and his women, man. So you can tell when it's a Jake and when it's a heathen, man.
Yep.
And in the spirit, you know, we mainly focus on Jacob and Esau because good is set against evil. Can you get that? I believe it's Ciroc 33. Ciroc 33, I want to say, in 8. I'll get it while you're reading that, brother. I'll get it for you.
Huh, it's Psalms 55, 21.
Yep.
The words of his mouth were smoother than butter, but war was in his heart.
Yeah, war was in his heart. And this is Jacob and Esau. I'll just read it if you want to break it down, brother. Ciroc or Ecclesiasticus 33 and 14, good is set against evil and life against death. So is the godly against the sinner and the sinner against the godly. So look upon all the works of the Most High, and there are two and two, one against another.
Hey, what's that, man? Jacob and Esau, man. And that's what this whole movie is about. All right, the Most High, he's the director. All right, the main characters that he chose, Jacob and Esau, man. All right, the heathens. All right, the main heathens. All right, versus the the chosen lineage, man. All right, you know, say good against evil. All right, the light against darkness, man. All right,
if I could, can I read this?
Yep.
Genesis, because this beautiful ties right in. Genesis 25 and 23, and the Lord said unto her, two nations are in thy womb, and two manner of people shall be separated from thy bowels.
Beautiful.
And the one people shall be stronger than the other people, and the elder shall serve the younger.
That's right, man. Two manner of people, man. All right. You got the good say against the evil, man. All right. And that two manner of people talking about the Edomites and the Israelites, man.
Mm-hmm.
And the Israelites are the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. And the Edomites are just the so-called white people, man.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And right now it says, what it say? Read the last line, Bob.
Genesis 25 and 23 says, two manner of people shall be separated from thy bowels, and the one people shall be stronger than the other people.
Right. It said two manner of people. All right. So you may have a confusion of face. You know, he may look like an Edomite, but, you know, you got to be spiritual, you know, and try that spirit, man. Because you can clearly tell from Jake, a confusion face Jake, and compared to an Edomite, man. All right, confusion face Jake, you know, he got, even though they wicked, they got integrity. You know, Jake still
got a zeal.
Right, got a zeal. You know, got some kind of morals. But on the other hand, you got these fucking Edomites. They're just dirty. They're vile beasts. They don't do shit. You know,
they're lewd.
The water, they're lewd, man. Or profane outside the temple.
I was trying to be gay.
Right, Hey, the natural sodomites, man.
Yep.
You know, and it said the younger shall serve the.
It says That one people shall be stronger than the other people, and the elder shall serve the younger.
The elder shall serve the younger, man.
The first shall be last, and the last shall be first.
Right,
and Esau came out first.
That's right.
See?
Came out first, man. You know, and hey, man, we're going to soon take over everything, man.
Yep.
And right now, you've seen it, man. You got Jake out here in the fucking suburbs more and more. You got mm-hmm. Jake riding bikes out here.
Yep.
The whole family's just coming out here and living out here, so-called, man.
You're seeing the curses be on Esau.
Yep.
You're seeing the Edomites. Hey, we just watched a video. Yep. Two Edomites winning a damn duel in their back alley, man,
yep.
over trash. That's evil eye towards a brother.
Yep.
You got Egyptian versus Egyptian.
That's prophecy, man.
That's prophecy.
Things gonna be in a bigger scale, man. When all hell breaks loose, man, you gonna have a civil unrest.
Hey,
you know.
Hey, you Edomites don't realize you may be ushering Jacob's trouble, but the true men of the Lord on the highways and hedges are ushering Edomite trouble.
That's right, man.
You know.
Right.
Hey, you finish that off and then get 1 Samuel 16:7.
Psalm 55:21. It says. The words of his mouth were smoother than butter,
yeah.
but war was in his heart.
Yeah.
His words were softer than oil, yet were they drawn swords.
Yeah. Yeah. And then jump to page 272.
272?
Yeah, that's 1 Samuel 16:7. Uh-huh. Yeah, yet were they drawn swords. So you could be speaking with an Edomite, and you could tell, hey, you could tell when a Jakes are planting you and when an Edomites are planting
yeah.
you.
Yeah.
All right? You gotta be able to read spirits, man.
Uh-huh.
Like how in the Super Saiyans, what's that, Dragon Ball Z? They got that reader.
They got that scouter.
Yeah,
that's called a scouter. My bad, Shalakia.
No, I'm saying that scouter. That you got to have that spiritual reader, man.
Yep.
You got to be able to scout and read spirits.
Wow.
Oh, that's a Jake. Oh, that's a heathen.
Yep.
And then you got to carry yourself in like manner. And just because it's a Jake don't mean you're going, oh, what's up, Shalom? You an Israelite.
Exactly.
They don't give a shit, man. If they two-thirds, they two-thirds. All we just saying is, hey, when you brothers run into a confusion of faith, Jake, don't let a demon jump on you and make you think that the whole nation is cool just because Jake integrated with a wicked nation.
Right.
Right.
Read. It says that Ephraim, hey, you know, Ephraim, you know, he joined against idols, was like not against idols,
with the murderer,
he joined amongst idols.
Yeah,
and they say leave him the hell alone, man.
Yeah, he joined the idols, leave him alone.
Right.
And real quick, Jake, before you get that, give me Micah 5:7,
huh?
Real fast and the quick fly, and then I gotta read this though. This is 1 Maccabees 1:33, start at 34. It says, and they are Edomites, so-called Greeks. This is history, all right? Alexander the Greek, he reigned for his 12 years, then his kingdom was split up into his four generals, and then it was divvied out, okay? Ptolemy, Cassander, Lysimachus, and Seleucus.
Yep.
Real quick. 1 Maccabees 1:34, and they put therein a sinful nation, wicked men, and fortified themselves therein. So right here is showing you, and I'll jump to 36, for it was a place to lie in wait against a sanctuary and an evil adversary to Israel.
Yep.
So you got Esau mixed among Jake and Jake mixed among Israel. Read that real quick.
This is the book of Saint Micah 5:7, and it says, and the remnant of Jacob shall be in the midst of many people.
Amidst of who?
Of many people.
Right. And what happened? What was the parable? The wheat and the tare. Right. So we got mixed in sleeping with their women and oppression. And they mixed in with us through rape and oppression, man.
Yeah.
So you got to be able to discern spirits. This is why you have Jake looking the way they do. A COF, a confusion of face. That is a part of the curse. The only reason there's confusion of faces is because that proves we're a defeated nation. One of our laws is not to let them marry our sons and daughters, man. You see, so once they were able to take our sons and our daughters and sleep with them and create more of their children through our women, all right, they integrated, and that proves we're defeated, man.
Yep.
All right, read that again.
And it said, Micah 5:7, and the remnant of Jacob shall be in the midst of many people,
yep.
as a dew from the Lord Yahweh Shemal Shai, as the showers upon the grass that tarrieth not for man, nor waiteth for the sons of men.
Hey, it says as a rain upon the grass.
Huh.
Hey, you go first of all, go look how much grass is out there, and then think about the rain or the dew falling on
right.
it, man. That's, hey, we have the sand of the sea and drops of the water, man, on the grass, you
right.
know. Now get 1 Samuel 16. So now that we know that Esau's mixed among us, now we know that Jake's mixed among the nations, what spirit do you got to be in?
Yep.
Right, read this.
It's 1 Samuel 16 and verse 7, right?
Yeah.
It says, but the Lord Yahweh Shemashiah said unto Samuel, look not on his countenance or on the height of his stature, because I have refused him. For the Lord Yahweh Shemashiah seeth not as man seeth, for man looketh on the outward appearance, but the Lord Yahweh Shemashiah looketh on the heart.
All right. The Most High looketh on the heart, the spirit.
Right.
So you may think you're seeing a Edomite, so-called African, a so-called Asian, right? And then you thinking that, but then when you really get to know him, you're like, yo, this is a nigga.
Yep.
This is a Jake.
Yep, and that spirit, because the brother, our camp leader, Marar, he did a video last night talking about how the Most High put a difference between the Israelites and Hamites.
Beautiful.
And that's true, man. We're not the Israelites. We have salt, man.
Yep.
We have everything that the heathen want, man.
Yeah.
Because the Most High chose, you know, you got Esau, Amalek, he want to be us.
Mm-hmm.
You got Ham want to cook like us, man. You got everybody want to dance, you know. You just want to be imitations of Jake, man.
Hey, the best thing that ever happened to you stink ass Africans was Esau claiming that we were you.
Yep.
That's the best thing that ever happened to you.
Yep.
You know what I mean? Because anything Jake do over here, they give props to Africa.
Yep.
They ain't doing none of the shit Jake doing over here, man. Unless it's Jake's mingled amongst them over there.
Huh.
All right? That's the only flavor that you nations got going for you is the Jakes that are mingled among you.
Right.
And that's every nation, man. Any rap superstar in Russia, Hong Kong.
Yep.
What's that song, Made in China?
Made in China.
What's their names?
The Hyra Brothers.
The Hyra Brothers, all right?
Hyra, Shalaki, Hyra.
Yep, them, yep. All right? All over, even down to the fake Jew rapper, man. This one dude, he's a Jew, he looks a so-called Jew, and he's rapping his ass off. It's a Jake, man.
Yep.
You got Jakes actually among fake Jews practicing fucking fake Judaism, man.
Prime example. Drake or Mac Miller.
Drake, yep.
Those are actual Jews or Israelites that were born into that Judaism bullshit.
The movie 999.
Oh,
Jake's son was had the, what is it, yarmulke?
The zit, something like that.
Yeah,
you say?
Yeah, the zits, but he also had the, what was that on top of the
black
head?
Hat, yarmulke.
Yarmulke, yep. Yeah, he even had that, remember?
Yep.
He was in Israel eating lamb, celebrating the Shabbat.
Yep.
You see? And Jake's everywhere, man. Jake's everywhere. Read what you got, brother.
This is a book of 2 Chronicles 1. And it's 9. It says, Now, O Lord of power, let thy promise unto David my father be established. For thou hast made me king over a people like the dust of the earth and multitude. Right, man? Like the dust of the earth, man. You know, dust in the sand of the sea. You know, a speckled bird everywhere, man.
Hey, get that. Get that in Rev. 7.
Yeah.
Nations, kings.
Yep.
The nations probably ended on that.
Huh.
And I will get the blue letter. Yeah, man, the main point we wanted to make, though, was brothers, don't let a confusion of face put demons on you and make you think that these heathen nations is cool, right, man, just because they seem like a cool-ass East Indian.
Right.
You know, I met some cool-ass Ishmaelites, and those are Jakes.
Yeah.
Hey, it's a spirit I even think about, not saying, you know, just since a point on it, there's times where I'll think about past times of me meeting people in the world and be like, man, that was a Jake. That ain't no, you know, such and that's a Jake, man.
Right.
That's an Israelite, you know? So, hey, brothers got to be spiritually discerned, man.
Right.
Because we coming into some times where brothers be saying you're going to have so-called Koreans come to camp, so-called East Indians, so-called Africans. And guess what? They're not going to be coming up scoffing as Jakes. They're going to be coming up seeking the word, man.
Because
also you got confusion of faces that are battling demons of not coming to camp or showing their face thinking they're going to get cursed out. So you confusion of face Jakes out there got to have faith that the true men of the Lord are out here and they'll accept you, man.
Yep.
All right? Because, hey, bro, there are true men out here that are moved by the Spirit. Prophecy is going to get fulfilled, man. All right? Read that.
This is the book of Revelation 7, verse 9. After this, I beheld, and lo, a great multitude, which no man can number.
Yeah, a great multitude. You got to remember, there's 144,000 elect, and then there's one-third, man. All right? Keep going.
And it says, which no man can number of all tongues,
yeah,
and kindreds, and people,
yeah,
and it's like my bad. And it says, of all nations, and kindreds, and people, and tongues, stood before the throne, and before the Lamb, clothed with the white robes and palms in their hands, and cried with a loud voice, saying, salvation to our power, which sitteth upon the throne and unto the Lamb.
Right. Now, read that again. All right. And we're going to break it down what it means. All right. Now, read it.
And it says, the book of Revelation 7 and verse 9. After this, I beheld, and lo, a great multitude which no man can number.
Right. All these people, Jake scattered everywhere. They were set up to be delivered. Right. Keep going.
Of all nations.
Why all nations? Because Israel is mixed himself among the people. He says, the sand of the sea is the dust of the earth. So Jake's everywhere. This is why it's all nations. And why do you think the scriptures say this gospel shall be preached to all nations? Because Jake is scattered everywhere. You see? All right, keep going.
And it says, and kindreds.
Yeah, and it says what?
And kindreds.
Right. Now, when you go into this word kindred, okay, which we're going to click right now, you see? So when you go into this word kindred, we're just going to...
Strong's G, 5443.
Foulé. All right. Foulé, which it goes into a tribe. In the New Testament, all the persons descending from one of the 12 sons of the patriarch Jacob.
Ooh.
And that proves that you are by your father.
That's right.
Because it says the sons of the patriarch Jacob, man. All right. So when it says the nations, it's talking about Jake scattered, and the kindred, meaning the people in that, though, out of those nations, are Israelites. That's right. And they're Israelites by their father, man. You are what your father is, okay? Right. So you can have an Edomite mother, you can have a Japanese mother, you can have a Elamite mother, you can have an Ammonite mother, Moabite mother, Ishmaelite mother, Hamite mother.
Hey, yo, King David had a Moabite mother.
A grandmother. Yeah, Ruth.
Yep.
Yeah. Or right. Yep. You see? Oh, Moses' sons had an Ethiopian mother.
Yep.
You see? But you are what your father is, man. That's why that Jake chick just won the finals, man.
Right.
The U.S. Open. She beat a big ass that nigga, the Serena Williams.
Yeah, do that.
That big ass nigga woman, man.
Right. And she's you know, people in the world they call her Japanese or mixed. But nah, man, she's a Levite.
Yeah.
She looks Japanese, you know, but nah, she's a Levite, man. Her father's a so-called Haitian.
Yep.
You know?
That's right. Yep, she's a Levite, man. Read that again.
The book of Revelation 7 verse 9. After this I beheld, and lo, a great multitude which no man could number.
Yeah.
Of all nations and kindreds.
Yeah, and the kindreds, and we proved the kindreds was who? Israelites.
Yep.
Right? And it said in what?
All nations and kindreds and people.
And the people, now if you go into the word people, all right, it goes in a people, group, tribe, nation. See, it says a nation. All those who are the same stock and language, man. So when it says same stock, that means the Israelites.
Yep.
You see? So these are Israelites that are coming from all nations, but they are Israelites by the Spirit, by their father, man.
Right. It says that, what's that, Numbers 18?
Number 1 and 18. Like, you are of your father.
The pedigrees of their fathers, man.
Yeah.
Meaning they're the seed, man, the stock.
Yep, so read that and end it on that.
Back to Revelation.
Unless you got anything.
I do, actually.
Okay.
You know, just so you know, further the point.
Come.
You know, this is the book of...
finish that.
Rev 7 and verse 9, my best
friend. Are you getting ready? Yeah.
It says, after this I beheld, and lo, a great multitude. Right, a great multitude, man. There's going to be many confusing faces, man.
Mm-hmm.
And it says, which no man can number, of all nations and kindreds and people, and tongues, and that proves that we're not the so-called minorities. We're the majority.
Yeah.
Esau is the minority along with the other heathens. And it says, and people and tongues stood before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed with the white robes and palms of their hands.
There you go, man. Those are Jakes.
Yep.
You see? Those are Israelites. But the point of the matter is, do not let a confusion of faith, Jake, mislead you to Esau's wickedness, man. All right? Because you can meet a cool-ass dude who you think's an Edomite and it's a Jake, man.
Yep.
All right. Or if it's not a Jake, and you know what I'm saying, don't also allow the Most High letting your enemies be at peace with you. Don't allow that to throw your judgment off.
Right.
Understand judgment, man.
Huh.
Read that.
This is the book of St. Isaiah 11 and verse 11. And it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord shall set his hand again the second time to recover the remnant of his people, which shall be left from Assyria, and from Egypt, and from Patros, and from Cush, and from Elam, and from Shinar, and from her mouth and from the island, and from the islands of the sea. Mm. Right, man. You got Jake's over there, still over there, Syria still.
Damascus.
Right, Damascus, India. Yeah. Everywhere, man. Jake is everywhere, man. Yeah. The islands.
Iraq,
everywhere, man. You know, so you can't get around it, man. The Holy Bible is about Israel, man.
Yeah, you should be able to tell a Jake from a heathen, man.
Kind of, yep.
You could tell, man. You could tell a Jake from a heathen, man.
Yep.
You know?
You know, ain't gonna have some brothers getting delivered from the four corners of the earth, man.
That's right.
Everywhere, man.
That's right.
All right.
Yeah. You good, brother?
Time.
Hey, so you know, with that, Lord's will, you brothers were edified through the Spirit as we were. And we just want to say, call law, Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai, Ba'ashem, Rachal Kodash. With that being said, Shalom. Mm-hmm.